14. I'm in 9th grade, and I'm from Ralston Middle School.
Let's go! Let's go!
This poem has trigger warnings, suicide, self-hate, transphobic insults, dysphoria. This monster with vacant voids for eyes has haunted the corner of my sight for all of my life. I can envision it at night where the pale moonlight gently caressed its gray callous skin. Its head hung over my bed like a grotesque mobile spewing out a tangled mess of lies. Over time, they began to unwind, ripping into my skin, allowing the stinging heat of self-hate and discomfort to settle in. Terrified, I kept my tortured screams on the inside, for I knew something is wrong, its name on the tip of my tongue. I want to ask my mother, but I am too afraid to be seen as a freak with meat feelings filling up my head every time I go to bed. Yet the wires pulled tighter, the acidic sting triggered by my out-of-place face. When I entered middle school, the burns began to cool. I had finally found others of my kind, friendly and accepting, relating to the mess running through my mind. With every pronoun correction that slips from my friend's lips, the monster steps back, weakened from the lack of fear. My self-esteem began to build up, which caused me to be with confidence, which led me to call a family conference. I recall standing in front of my family with my pounding heart, my eyes locked with my mother's. Her orbs were a melted brown welcoming me. But as my dirty confession began to drip from my lips, forming a puddle underneath my feet, their stares had transformed into sharp glares. My father shot up with arms crossed. He demanded for me to leave the room. I was just 13 then. Apparently, I had no idea who I am. Yet my brother, who was just 10, knew that he liked girls with tight curls and glossy blue eyes. Now, I am 16. My feet are hanging over the edge of the bed while I watch the ribbons of moonlight dance through my window. After years of being stuffed in poofy, goofy dresses, tonight is the night where I get to wear what I feel fit. It isn't much. I stare into the closet where no light can reach, yet my eyes are still able to trace its distorted form. My right hand grasps the pills, knowing that I might choke with my tight, dry throat. My cumbersome body is numb, head to toe. I don't want to cry. It's just too hard. My right hand lays on my bottom lip while I try to soothe myself with the thought that I might be able to rest. I swallowed hard before I stared at my haunting ghost. You can't touch me! I am free! I know this, but its reaction was faster. Before I knew it, it was already latching on. The monster worked like a noose. I can't breathe. Dyke, tranny, fake boy, Pinocchio, the lethal smoke of those insults clogged my head and my nose. I can't breathe! I fall back onto my bed. Images of me wearing a dress while in a casket stain my eyes as they boil up with tears. I can't breathe. My world grows darker. It finally registers with me that I will not be seen as I want to be seen. I can't breathe. This is my leave that has me staring at my choking stalker. I can't breathe.